Hi everyone, my name is Mrs. and today I'm going to be making a tutorial on no one fucking cares who you are. Also, I'm not a child, I can read the title, I know what this video is about, stop wasting my time. There are three rules on YouTube. Title and thumbnail get people to click, first 5 seconds get them to stay, rest of the video gets them to come back. If you're making a tutorial, your title should be clear and concise. How to make X in X tool. That's it. And also, personally, I like to add in X amount of time because it says, hey, I'm not going to waste your time. Then the thumbnail should just be the final product. No dumb shit ass Photoshop BS where it's like, oh, I'm going to make a platformer so I'll have a picture of a guy jumping. No, that's stupid. Just show the final product. But that would require me to make a final product that actually looks good. Yes. It's so easy to find free art assets that look good online. You can go on OpenGameArt. You can check out Kenny. There's so much free legal stuff you can use that you have no excuse to make something that looks bad. And also you can put the icon of the tool you're using in one corner of the thumbnail. Just don't put it on the bottom right because then the timestamp will cover it. Okay, now for the video itself. First 3 to 5 seconds of the video, show the final product and restrain the urge to say some stupid fucking bullshit like, hey guys, this is what we're gonna be making today. No, really? I never would have guessed. Instead, say something actually useful like links to all the assets are in the description. And speaking of assets, any assets you're gonna use in the video, you should put them in the most easily accessible places possible. Like any 3D art or video or sound effects or anything like that, put it in a zip file, upload it to OpenGameArt. Don't put it on your own website because you might stop paying for hosting and then no one will ever be able to access those files again. Put it on a main public website where it's easy for everyone to access forever. If you're doing programming projects, put the final project on GitHub, obviously, and have a link to that. And each code script should be on individual pastebin links as well, because with GitHub, you have to click the link, then click view code, then find the file, click it, then click raw, and then you can copy and paste from it. Whereas with pastebin, it's just one click and you're there. You should constantly be asking yourself, how can I not waste people's time? Okay, now onto the video itself. Here's what you're gonna do.
All right, I'm gonna start a new project here. I'm just gonna add a new blank node 2D here, and then add another. You can just hit Control A to add a node instead of clicking the plus there. I'm gonna add in a sprite.
Make a new project. Do this, do this, do this. Here's why we're doing this. Here's why we're doing this. Do this, so on until you're done. Something I like to do when I was making tutorials is I would run through the whole thing at least 2 or 3 times. So make the project in the first place and make it as if I was teaching someone and speak out loud what I'm doing and stuff like that. Then I run through the whole thing again, start to finish, and record it as if, you know, I'm making the tutorial now, and then pay attention to where I make mistakes, where I stumble explanations and have trouble, and then I practice those parts in my head, and then I go through and I run through the whole thing again. And this time it's pretty smooth and there's almost no mistakes at all. The benefits of doing this is there's almost no editing required and it just flows really smoothly from start to finish and it's just clear and concise. No time wasted, right? Now, one tip, if you're doing programming tutorials aimed at people who aren't beginners, something I did was I would have all my code written up on a separate monitor. And then when I went to go and write code, I would just copy and paste every line in one at a time and explain each line as I did that. More advanced programmers don't really want to watch you write code. That's kind of boring and a waste of time. They just want to know what features and methods are available with this tool, or they want to know how to write a certain algorithm and they just want to hear your explanation and see your examples. Seeing you write code is just a waste of time for them. It's also good for you when you copy and paste in the code because it's less error prone. If you go to run your code, you're almost never going to have a syntax error, which makes it easier for you to record your tutorials. Okay, now you've gone through and you've finished the tutorial, you've made the final product. You have now hopefully earned the respect of the viewer and you can say whatever you want, like thanks for watching, please subscribe. And I also heavily recommend making a course, sell it for like $10 to $12 on Udemy or Gumroad or something like that, and promote it at the end of every single one of your tutorials because you deserve to be paid for your work and YouTube ad revenue isn't that great. So anyways, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you'd like to support me. Check out my game development tutorials. I have one on how to make retro style 3D graphics and one on how to make a retro style 3D FPS. I also have a game on Steam called Deus Ex. It's a top-down shooter where you levitate guns. Links in the description.